What is this left side front door problems? They used for a rational sampling. What is this rational sampling? Various type of sampling you might have learned, but Honda is practicing this rational sampling. Various type of probabilistic sampling, non-probabilistic sampling. Probabilistic sampling, you are knowing about the simple random sampling. Simple random sampling, you are knowing very judgmental, convenient, other type of non-probabilistic. But so Honda is practicing this random rational sampling. Rational samples are a group of measures whose variation is attributed only to the constant system of common cause. Samples should be chosen to minimize the occurrence of a special cause within the sample. Sampling from different machines over an extended period of time and products from several sources should be avoided. Sample size should be relatively, you must take 3 to 6. So what they did, they have taken a time slot from morning 6 and up to 9:20, they have taken a slot time of this slot, and from the assembly line they have taken a first sample, second sample. Timing of the first sample is 6:30 to 6:40 hours. In 6:30 to 6:40 hours is the first sample, and they got the variance points x1, x2, x3, x4, x5. These are the various points they got it. And finally, they calculated their x bar mean, and then they calculated their range, and then finally they calculated their S. S is a standard deviation. Standard deviation, why we are not talking about sigma, because it is not a population's standard deviation, it is a sample's standard deviation. That's why we are representing with small s. And then we have taken first sample, second sample, and third sample. All the timings we have given: first timing 6:30 to 6:40, 7:30 to 7:40, 8:30 to 8:40. Like that, three samples we have decided. All the values, x1, x2, x3, x4, values we have taken, calculated their x bar, range, and finally the standard deviation. One can use the statistics software also for calculating. And this is the rational sampling all about. Honda was talking about control chart. So control chart, two type of control chart. One is X bar chart, other one is R chart. Two type of charts we are going to focus here. So this is the chart where we have already demonstrated various standard deviation. If the plus minus one sigma is there, then the sample you will get 68.39% out of 100% if you are practicing plus minus one sigma. If you are practicing plus minus three sigma, in that case you are getting a 95.5% of the sample, and if you are practicing plus minus four sigma, then you can get 99.7% of the whole, out of 100%, 99.7% of the product and services will come as your product and services, and remaining will get rejected. So Six Sigma concept, where you are getting 99.9999, something like 6-7%, you are taking as a samples, and only 3.4 defect per million you are rejecting it. That is the Six Sigma practice. Generally this is there. So based on that, this is the six X bar chart and R bar chart we are practicing.